Welcome back to Final Fantasy VII. And
how
now...
I go on.
Shut up, Dwayne. And now
not
we're starting these two.
I'm so sad.
You know, actually, this makes me wonder. Now that we've gotten to the death, I wonder if maybe for the remake, you know, since everyone knows that Aerith dies,
glorious
I wonder.
HD, blood and all. Yeah, we know.
Well, I was wondering actually if maybe for the remake, though, maybe they'll change things up a bit. Not necessarily changing who dies, but maybe make it an option that Aerith doesn't have to die, but instead a different member has to die. And again.
Not.
They're not gonna do that. Hold on.
Let me finish.
Not only because it contradicts a lot of things with the rest of the compilation, but because Aerith's death triggers specific kind of events that only her can trigger.
Oh, good point. But as I was saying, it's like, well, especially since this game
I wouldn't mind instead seeing a change of an option where Cloud actually goes apeshit and kills her instead of Sephiroth. That would be an interesting twist.
Allow me to finish up my thoughts exactly, Miko. I didn't mean like, well, one player designated has to die. I was like, well, saying like maybe based on the player's choices, someone else might die. Especially like, well, since this remake is speculated to go, you know, beyond the ending of Final Fantasy VII, and it may do like, you know, a bit of stuff from the compilations.
That's understandable, Joe. I mean, the ending of Final Fantasy VII will not spoil it yet for the two of us who don't know, but it's open. It's open. It was opened. Even with the post-credit scene, it's still an open ending. But since we made the rest of the compilation, they practically said what the ending is. So there's no point anymore in making it open.
Oh, I know that. I know that. But I'm saying is like, well, I mean, like, well, under the spectrum.
My guess it's they will basically implement something that was said in the novels or in some materials like what's the name? One of the OVAs, not Lost Order, but one of the other OVAs.
Maybe a bit of Advent Children too, since they mentioned a reunion.
Okay. One thing that I hope they put in the remake is when we get to the optional a certain optional flashback regarding a certain character in Cloud's past that Taylor knows what I'm talking about. I hope they take a cue from Crisis Core, because even though I didn't like Crisis Core story for the most part, I did think it did a good job in doing a cinematic version of the ending of that flashback, and I do love the legacy line. Taylor knows what I'm talking about.
It's too cheesy.
There's the legacy line.
I like that.
Too cheesy, and two, it's shot like every single yaoi fan fiction you ever seen.
I thought it worked fine in the contest. I thought the game earned that, at least. Yeah. I don't know.
It's Crisis Core on PSP 1.
Yes. Like and the way Adventure Incomplete also implemented that, I thought that was also a pretty nice touch that I liked. It was a nice way for them to give a specific phrase that really helps make that particular moment more memorable to me, at least. I thought the line was fine. Like,
Cloud, why are we running away like chickens?
Because Aerith, we can't get grinding fatigue.
Aerith's dead, you
I mean Yuffie.
Not to mention, Teo, let's not pretend that the dialogue in this game can't get cheesy, because it can.
The
dialogue they were saying when they were mourning Aerith was like, for me, it was like,
yes, Dreams. There are entire internet videos dedicated that said that basically it's a chewing the scenery moment.
She's dead, we will mourn.
You know, yes. I haven't really seen much since I haven't even seen the full game yet, even though I did buy it today. I will say that I hope they at least tweak the problems that the game had and keep as much as they possibly can in 2015.
Well, according to Nomura, that's pretty much what they're trying to do, because Nomura...
Yeah, the game...
Because there's nothing overly wrong with this game, so...
I agree.
Well, the remake. Well, they said the remake isn't going to be no fun allowed or anything.
And they seem to be showing quite a few funny moments.
Probably already said Nomura already tranquilized everybody and said, yes, you will see Cloud not dressed in a female costume. Don't worry.
Cloud, why am I shrunken?
Monsters.
Sorry, Lightning, you're out of the way.
I'm suspecting that the biggest changes we will see in the main plot will be basically implementation of Yuffie and Vincent in the main story instead of being just optional, and probably other side activities being mandatory this time around. Maybe fleshing even more out for Condor or something. I don't know.
I really like this game, so...
I can speak for those side activities because we don't know which ones are, but when it comes to making Yuffie and Vincent obligatory, that actually, in my opinion, is a very positive improvement, because I always felt like Vincent at the very least should have been obligatory, because he does have a quite important role.
I won't spoil anything, because we will see later on. Yes. Don't worry, this part around is just climbing and shit.
Oh, goody!
I'm not going to spoil
anything, but Vincent is a huge missed opportunity in this game. Another reason why I like these digital servers, because it expanded more on his backstory too. But in this game, Vincent, despite receiving a backstory, he doesn't receive too much. It's just left out a bit in the open for you to interpret. It gives you just some bonus scenes that makes you understand the story even more, but nothing that stands really out. Digital servers expand greatly in that, so that's an improvement. So I hope that in the remake, Vince will be integrated and expanded a bit more.
So here's a question I have.
Hopefully they'll take a cue from Digital Servers and maybe insert some of the plot points in the flashbacks. That would be a good idea.
Speaking of which, do you think that this... considering canon-wise, how canon do you think this remake will be considered, especially if it changes up a few things, which they have hinted at?
It will ultimately depend on when it will come out, Jova, honestly, because we cannot give a proper opinion just now.
What I'm assuming is they're probably going to make specific alterations to make sure it fits better with the compilation.
It's almost certain that we're gonna see
the legacy line that I was talking about. It's almost certain that we're gonna see that line in the flashback.
The problem is, Pedro, a lot of elements get contradicted terribly between each chapter of the compilation. Specifically the Evelyn accident. All the Advent Children and Dirge Server don't talk about, but the other chapters, each of the other chapters have a specific version of their own. We actually don't know which version is actually the correct one. But even though the last order is a completely different one. That's actually bullshit to me, but...
Yeah, the Last Order one, like, what the fuck? Like, they literally completely changed.
We will talk that about more later once we'll get to the proper Nibelheim flashback, because it will drop back up. But trust me, each version has its own Nibelheim flashback.
Okay, Joey, what was it?
Oh
no, all I was gonna say was, I'm sure they won't change too much, because this is a very loved game.
Yeah,
they could either change.
This is the case where if you fuck it up, you're gonna get lynched.
But then again, Square could do anything and they'll still probably get lynched by some people, no matter what they do.
And at the same time, they could do practically anything and will probably steal this game like hotcakes, because everyone will pre-order it instantly because it's Final Fantasy VII.
That brings me... I have an idea to bounce off of you guys. Let me know if it sounds a bit too far-fetched. I wonder if maybe for this remake, they'll still include the original plot, but I'm wondering if maybe they'll include, like, an ability to, you know, alter the plot in the remake. It's a win-win. Say they had the regular ending, but then say there were alternate sequences or whatnot.
I don't know, Joba, honestly.
What was that, Troy? Kingdom Hearts is alternate endings? Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah, I guess something like that. Imagine for, like, the remake now. Okay, don't take me too seriously, but for an example, let's say that they actually change something that you, by a very complex sequence of events, you can make it so that Aerith does not die, and that we're, say, an alternate ending.
And they all live happily ever after the end.
That wouldn't work.
Well, honestly...
To be fair, among the fandom of this game, there's a huge community that for years speculated about a way to resurrect Aerith in game, and people who actually use the Game Shark codes to do that. So I would not discard that entirely.
Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, which goes back to my question, I mean, I wonder how
people be talking about as if she's dead. Doesn't know, could it be for
behold, they were brought back to life by the power of the Game Shark. Look out, it's the killer rabbit!
Cloud, you're an asshole!
No, don't burn the bunny.
What the
fuck? Enemies in this particular era are basically ice-themed, so it's logical to burn them.
What, behind the rabbit? It is the rabbit. You did. Because this one, I'm so scared. Well, that's no ordinary rabbit. Look at the bones and the teeth.
Monty Python.
Yeah. Going back to my, about my idea about the alternate ending scenes, that sort of went back to my question on, like, I wonder how big this game will extend. Since we already have, you know, practical word about it, you know, extending past the ending, so I'm wondering if maybe this might also include maybe a watered-down adaptation of some of the compilation.
I actually wonder if they will keep the dungeon and world map system, or they will change it to something similar to 10, I guess. I mean, Square show they can still do the proper world map and see this thing, but I don't know. Or so, maybe they will do huge areas like in 15.
So let's
I don't know.
To make it things easier for them, they should just do the classic world map thing.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, there's one thing I wanted to talk about remake-wise. Are they going to do the music?
Orchestral. Yeah.
Simple. Orchestral.
If they're smart, they will remix them, but include the option to
have the original
like the PS4 version of 10 and 10.2.
Yeah, I mean, there's a...
It's one thing for 10, because 10 already had much better instrumentation, but to have...
regardless of how 10.2 is crappy, one complaint that people had for the HD Final Fantasy X PS3 version was that you could not have the original music as an option.
This is a good time for me to bring up. Yeah, I think I get why people like some of the original tracks. I don't quite know what exactly the instrumentation of it, but like in the case of Final Fantasy VII's battle theme, there's this great instrumentation that, well, you know, is not replicated in the orchestral version.
A reminder, I don't know you guys, but the only version of the remix of the boss theme of Final Fantasy VII that I actually liked was the one by the Black Mages.
Oh, me too! That's the only one I liked as well.
All other remixes were really, really crappy, honestly.
Was that Black Mages? Isn't that Nobori Matsu's band?
Yeah. Anyway, I should explain a bit where we are. This is the Icicle Inn village.
Oh.
It's basically a village situated in the north, buried in snow.
So
basically, it's a peak point where people who love snowboard and mountain climbers get back together each other in order to start excursion to the huge mountain that was in the background, which is where Sephiroth is headed, and we're going to we have to go after him, basically.
Oh, I remember
and
this section.
And we'll need things like a map, for instance. So let's take it from the wall, shall we?
Like yeah, let's do it.
It's for a good cause. Yuffie, you steal that map.
Actually, there's a character who will say in a bit.
I just get so comfortable.
The master is an experienced climber, you know. I heard that he knows every... Fuck.
Every fuck. there he is, look.
Okay.
It's nearly impossible to reach the Northern Limits without a map. You thinking about going to the Northern Limits, you better take that map for a while. What, nerve? You already tore down the map! Okay, so we... Yep, that's right, he would have given it to us anyway.
I was compelled by my point-and-click... Yeah. Remember, each point-and-click protagonist is affected by amnesia, usually, and kleptomania.
Yeah. Going back to what I was saying, because honestly, to me, Teo, having this particular instrumentation in a PS4 game would feel out of place to me.
Not necessarily. Well, I mean,
honestly, I know the track will be remixed. What the fuck?
What are you looking at?
I know the track will be remixed for sure. What I wonder if they will just leave that or include the original as a switchable bonus. I mean, other games did that even before Final Fantasy X, like Pokemon Heart Gold and Soul Silver.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of a bit of a lost art, like, well, with some sounds like this that, you know, they sound old, but honestly, there's a bit of a charm to them. I feel that a lot of times their orchestral remixes tend to lack.
Well, then again, you know my issues with this soundtrack, so an orchestral version would be welcome.
It depends.
There's nothing off an orchestral version. I just wish that either they would, you know, get it with both in, or, you know, have something to replicate, you know, maybe a more updated sound version of this. I mean, it's very well possible to make an updated version of it, but no one seems to really be daring enough to try, which
just have the exact same instruments, just use, well, real ones.
Yeah. Well...
And now the game just glitched to me.
The barman was supposed to turn around and talk to me about the actual instruments.
Yeah. Was he trying to make herself dizzy or something? Get back here with my mop, you asswipe!
It depends on how it's done. For me, for example, like, I love the Bowser stage themes for Mario 64, but the orchestral version of Galaxy 2 is, to me, the superior version, like the full orchestra, the choir.
I prefer the one from Mario Galaxy 1, honestly.
And then there's cases like Tension Rising from Kingdom Hearts 2. Sounds great and high-pitched in the PS2 version, yet for some reason they completely took away all the high-pitching in the orchestral one
We're about to get a huge chunk of cutscenes regarding Professor Gast and basically Aerith's mother. Dweebs, you'll be Professor Gast, and Pedro, you'll be Ifalna.
Wait, hold on, sure I was Aerith's mother.
I know, but the text is huge and not completely my control.
Yeah, true.
Fair enough. Go ahead, Pedro.
As soon as someone starts talking. Camera's ready.
Sure, why not?
Then, Ifalna, please tell us about the Cetra.
Okay. 1,000 years ago, our ancestors, the Cetra, heard the cries of the planet.
I do not look like Gordon Freeman, for Christ's sake.
The first ones to discover the planet's wound were the Cetra at the Knoll's Pole.
Gordon Freeman, is that you?
Tell us if...
No, because you told.
Where is the land called Knoll's Pole?
Knoll's Pole refers to this area. The Cetra then began a planet reading.
Ifalna, what exactly does planet reading entail?
I can't explain it very well, but it's like having a conversation with the planet.
Eyes.
God damn it, bad reception.
Hey, don't shoot the planet! That hurts it!
Oh, please, Jova. You're telling me that the planet is alive, but it has a spirit? That's a fairy tale. I will never get tired of that speech.
Yeah, I haven't even seen the movie, and it never gets old to me either.
But due to the severity of the wound, it was only able... Whatever.
Do the ancients, rather, etc., have special powers to heal the planet?
No, it's not that kind of power. The life force of all living things on this planet becomes the energy. The Cetra tried desperately to cultivate the land so as not to diminish the needed energy.
Lion King.
Wait, what? Lion
Even here, so close to the North Cave, the snow never melts. Yeah, this sounds like Lion King. When people die, they become the planet and stuff like that. Is that because the planet's energy is gathered here to heal its injury?
Yes, the energy that was needed to heal the planet rotted away the land. Then the planet...
The planet's still here.
The planet tried to persuade the Cetra to leave the Knoll's people, but...
Knoll's Pole.
Knoll's Pole.
Ifalna, let's take a break.
Yeah, this is the thing I never understood. If Ifalna just gets tired from just talking. I'm all right. When the Cetra were preparing to part the land they loved, that's when it appeared.
What?
It looked like our dead mothers and our dead brothers showing us specters of their past.
Sounds like a rap lyric.
Hmm.
It was the person that appeared at the North Cave. I haven't any idea.
That's when the one who injured the planet and Grammar, or the Crisis from the Sky, as we call him, we first approached as a friend, received them, and finally gave them the virus.
Keep that in mind, Drova, because it was brought up in Advent Children.
The Cetra were attacked by the virus and went mad, transforming into monsters.
You have to get around to sing Advent Children.
After we finish this game.
The complete version. Make exactly. Sure it's done. There's no reason to watch the original. It's a gigantic piece of crap. The approach to the Cetra plan. Oh, whatever.
Yeah, basically, I played this game and I
played. Let's call it a day.
Yeah, I talked, and talking for some reason makes me ill.
Maybe she was pregnant with Aerith at the time?
Yes, she was.
Ah, true. That explains it. Oh.
True, but come on.
And to be fair, Pedro, there are a lot of cases where being pregnant can make you so tired to the point where talking takes it out of you.
Hold on.
Oh, tape.
This is actually a bit more important because it will be brought up not too late.
Can you comment on the thing called weapon?
Oh, yeah. Yes, Professor.
Professor?
Oh, boy. Here we go. Well, he is Professor Gast.
The professor mistook for a Cetra was named Genova. That is, the Crisis from the Sky.
Dun dun dun.
The planet knew it had to destroy the Crisis from the Sky.
What it did know was that at the core there was another story.
You see, as long as Genova exists, the planet will never be able to fully heal itself.
Back then, weapon was a weapon the planet produced of its own will.
Yes, but there is no record of weapon ever being used.
Who wrote this script?
A small number of the surviving Cetra defeated Genova and confined it. Sadly, Professor, the translators of this game aren't very good.
Whatever. Continue. So, weapon no longer exists on this planet.
A weapon called weapon.
Weapon cannot vanish. It remains asleep somewhere on the planet.
Yeah, I gotta say this. This game has some of the most unimaginative names for items ever. The planet's called
Weapon. Actually,
that's
not the fault of the translator. It's called Weapon even in the Japanese version.
No, that's what I was talking about. In general, it's not very imaginative. Where is Weapon?
I don't know. I can hear the voice of the planet.
What bugs me a bit more is the fact that we're referring now when we refer later as weapon as a single entity, but as we will see, and sorry, but it's not a spoiler at this point, there are multiple weapons. So I don't know why we never refer to them as plurals.
That'll be all for today.
I'm probably guessing it's another translation error.
Or maybe Ifalna only knew about the one weapon.
Yeah, that's another definite improvement, a better fucking translation.
Yeah, that would be another improvement.
Okay, I do hope that they have
now see the confidential videos.
I do hope that in the remake, you know, I mean, they still keep the traditional, usual text box and, you know, don't have everything voiced. I mean, obviously they're...
What are you doing, Professor... Honey?
Oh, I'm thinking of editing it on video, but the video's not working right.
Are you going to tape? Is there still something I haven't mentioned?
Your breast size. No, that's not it. I'm going to record my beautiful daughter.
And I'll post on YouTube.
And when she's sleeping, her face looks like an angel.
Are you an angel?
First,
no,
let's figure
thank
out her name.
You.
We can take the video later. How about Barbara? I've already decided. If it's a girl, then it'll be Aerith. That's that. Why not just call her Barbara?
You're so selfish. But Aerith is a good name.
Then why are you calling me selfish then?
It's a good name. Wait, is this her?
I don't know. I can't
we don't
tell.
Know. Honestly, I didn't.
We don't know yet.
Oh, the videotape.
That's another reason why I wanted Shiroi to be spared from this. So let's see the last video on the tape.
Confidential. A sex tape between Professor Gast and Ifalna? Ooh.
So this time the video is actually working. Video again? You just got through taping.
Please don't say it that way.
What?
It's our lovely daughter. Both yours and mine.
Oh, so that's how Aerith was conceived.
Don't you want to capture her childhood on videotape? Oh, sorry, that was you. Sorry, Dibs.
Again,
if you keep
doting
on her like that, she will grow up to be strong.
Yeah, for some reason, they didn't put the names of the characters.
Aerith is different from the other children. I wonder what dangers await her.
You have no idea.
Never say that.
They seem to not do that.
You and Aerith, no matter what.
What was that, Joy?
You and Aerith are my only treasures. I'll never let you go.
Put the names above the text boxes in the flashbacks.
Mm-hmm. I feel so much better now, darling. If I hadn't met you, I.
Oh, knock knock, motherfucker!
Look at that! I was just about to. God damn! How dare they intrude on our private time together?
Preposterous!
I think this is him. Yes, or I can't even tell who the fuck is even saying this shit at this.
No, it's actually Ifalna.
Really?
Huh.
It's them.
Guess so. I've been searching for you, Ifalna. Or should I say, Cetra? Long time no see!
Long time no see!
Long time no see!
Long time no see!
Look forward to this line in HD, Pedro.
How did you know?
Voiced and all.
Believe me, I had to turn over a stone or two to find you. I froze my ass off, you know? 2 years I waited. That's how much I wanted this new sample. Science and shit.
New sample? You don't mean Aerith!
Aerith, what a nice name.
Though, personally, I prefer Aerith. Just kidding.
All ties at the Shinra. Hojo, please leave. What are you doing?
Please, Aerith has nothing to do with it. All I want is me, right?
I'll need all of you for my experiment.
You idiot!
You understand, don't you, Professor Gast? We can change the future of the planet.
Oh.
Yeah.
Don't worry, Ifalna. I'll take care of this.
Yeah, I'll be honest, I do prefer Aerith over Aerith.
Please don't put up a fight. I don't want any harm to come to my precious sample. What a funny looking camera. Guard, destroy it.
Hojo is addicted to cameras.
Ding! Like, seriously.
Like, seriously, what was even his intention exactly? A camera. Let's destroy it for a reason.
Maybe he knew.
Let's destroy it for the
Take
hell of
Aerith
it.
And run!
Maybe he knew someone would look at the tapes later and wanted to, not reveal what happened on it.
Oh, and don't forget the child. A video? The ancients? Weapon? A mountain of treasure. Thank you, Professor.
Yeah, it's something I never got. Okay, if he found the videos and he apparently took them, then why are the videos still here?
Just delete.
I think that's a videotape, not to mention...
I guess the best guest had the copies.
Or he just got careless.
More so the former.
Yeah, as you can see, they're all scattered on the ground and everything.
Yeah, and they
so
even
as you have seen, this is Professor Gast's house. This is where he lived with Ifalna, then we had Aerith, then Hojo came along and became a party pooper, pretty much.
Yep.
He stole Professor Gast's data, took Ifalna and Aerith, and went back to Midgar after, of course, killing Professor Gast.
No, don't! Oh. It's a steep downgrade past here! It's dangerous, please don't go!
We're gonna do
I'm
it
still
anyway.
Going.
Oh, damn, I was just being nice. What the? Who are those people over there? Looks like trouble.
And now, for some reason, we have a Looney Tunes style appearance.
Sure.
Oh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh,
yeah,
scrap.
I get in that kind of, they get that kind of appearance of L and I and the two Shinra soldiers. Whatever.
Cloud. I won't let you go any further.
Sure you can.
Nah. What's down there?
My shoes.
It's a secret.
Ah, okay.
It really doesn't matter, but you really got guts doing my boss in like that.
Yeah, again, they keep treating as if he's actually dead, but even though he's not.
Well, then again, to be fair, Pedro, did Elena know in the original version that Singh was really alive?
She knew. It's a problem with translation. This particular part, she says he's still alive. He's recovering from his injuries. That's another thing I would like to see in the remake, like an extra scene when we were seeing Sang being taken away from the Temple of the Ancients. Because Sang doesn't appear in the rest of the game at all after this.
Looks like talking alone won't cut it. You're going to have to feel some pain.
Oh boy!
Either way, she thinks we're responsible for what happened to Sang.
Okay, Pedro. Oh, no. For some reason here, I screwed up because there was input lag. Basically, what's gonna happen is Elena will try to punch us. We can either take it or easily duck it. The problem was with the keyboard controls, probably there was some sort of input lag, so I couldn't react fast enough.
Oh, wow.
Just to say what happens in the other... If she doesn't manage to punch you, she basically trips and falls all the way to basically the slide, and the guards goes after her.
So if this were GTA 5, when you get punched in the face, Cloud would have died instantly.
Yeah, but now for some reason, instead of arresting you, she just locks you, puts you back in Gast's house like nothing happens for some reason.
Maybe it was all a dream. I don't know.
No, because the guards are still in town. They prevent you from going away, as we will see probably in the next part.
Sorry, I just took off a while ago. Looks like there's going to be trouble. Anyhow, you need a snowboard to get down the hill. Want me to teach you how to ride one, or do you want to play the iOS game?
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Do you want me to explain again?
No, thanks.
So we need a snowboard. I remember someone who has a snowboard and cannot use it.
It's what Aerith would have wanted.
I guess. Stealing from others.
Or maybe we could just politely ask.
I got rid of my snowboard, now I can't go out for a while. Hey, I'll give you my snowboard.
Sure,
see?
It was expensive for your parents, so fuck them.
See, we don't have to steal everything. Some people will just be friendly enough to give it to us.
We didn't even need to ask.
No, you're just giving it and then, bam.
Questionable
morals.
Hey,
random kid.
This village is known to martial law. Stop it, there are kids around. Listen, I probably shouldn't tell you, but there's some business going up down north. The president's going to be here, so would you please just lay low for a while? And what was
with their rare?
I guess they know they do not stand a chance, and we just
No. I was talking about the error.
What error?
Oh.
T-H-E-Y apostrophe R-E.
Typos.
Wait. How was that an error? That was punctual, actually.
Typo.
How is that a typo?
Anyway,
T-H-E-Y?
Whatever. Anyway, we will use our newly acquired snowboard in the next part. See ya.
See ya.